My name is Donette Douglas. I'm the station manager here at WTJR Channel 16 in Quincy, Illinois. This is Behind the Scenes, a local program taped right in the studio right here at WTJR 222 North 6th Street in Quincy, Illinois. This program is to bring you information about what has been going on to WTJR. The week has been busy as always. We've been preparing, making plans for the CTN Fall Telethon, which means we're working on spot ideas, setting times to record some spots that you'll watch during the telethon. And I'll talk more about the telethon later on, but I would just encourage you to be a part of the telethon. Because you know, when you support WTJR, you are helping to reach someone with the gospel of Jesus Christ. You are planting the gospel seed. And we know that the word, when it goes forth, it has a purpose. It does not return void. And something happens to people when they hear the word of God. And you can be a part of that. You know, we reach all over the world. Think about that. We may think, oh boy, I wish I could help someone in Africa, in Central America, in Puerto Rico, in Haiti, in Canada, you know, or another state. Well, we can through WTJR. And we also now have four channels, as you all know. And so we're reaching even more people because we have a greater variety of programming. So people will find a program they like and tune in. And we're getting many good comments and good feedback from people about our four channels. But it's exciting to know that we're making a difference in somebody's life. We get testimonies. You know, I had a lady stop by one day, and she stopped by to drop off, I'm not sure what she was dropping, I think shoeboxes. Shoeboxes for the ministry at Christmas time to Mexico. And she said, I just want to share with you, I've been a caretaker for my daughter for the last 2 years. And I want you to know, and she said it with tears in her eyes, WTJR helped us through many hard days. That's just one testimony. I met a lady one day that shared that she had gave her heart to the Lord while watching A Woman's Joy on a WTJR program here. Praise God. And not only her, but now her husband and her two children go to church and give their heart to the Lord. See, we may not hear all the testimonies, but I know without a doubt that WTJR is making a difference in people's lives because we preach the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. The word changes lives. So when you support us, CTN WTJR, you are helping to invest in someone's life for eternity. Think about it, for eternity. So I just ask you to pray about what God would want you to do to be a part of the upcoming telethon. Okay? Well, I didn't mean to go down that rabbit trail, but I got started, so I wanted to finish it. But we're continuing on. We're praising God for prayer, but I have changed the scripture. We've changed the teaching about prayer is a little different now. We're praising God that He is moved by prayer. God is moved by prayer. That will get God's attention. Yes, it will. And so I'm going to give you some scriptures here, and especially when people have been in disobedience and they come back up, back to Him and are in obedience to Him, then prayer moves Him. Amen. Amen. Many of you maybe have seen the War Room movie. I have not seen it yet. I have plans maybe next week, hopefully, to see it. But I understand it's a very powerful movie. How one lady made such a difference in so many people's lives because she prayed for them. Amen. So we're praising God. He is moved by prayer. And here is our theme scripture for today. From 2 Samuel 24:25. And David built there an altar unto the Lord and offered burnt offerings and peace offerings. So the Lord was entreated for the land and the plague was stayed from Israel. Well, when we go to the NA NASB, which is the New American Standard Version of the Bible, it reads this way. David built there an altar to the Lord and offered burnt offerings and peace offerings. Thus the Lord was moved by prayer for the land, and the plague was held back from Israel. But when David came, brought his offering, brought his prayers, after being obedient to what God asked him to do. In the scriptures before, in chapter 24, Samuel, we find the people were rebellious. They had, turned against God, weren't following God. And then what happens when they come back to God? And David repented and he built an offering, or an altar, I should say, unto the Lord. So let's go to 2 Samuel 21 and 14. They buried the bones of Saul and Jonathan his son in the country of Benjamin in Zelah, in the grave of Kish his father. Thus they did all that the king commanded. And after that, God was moved by prayer for the land. God likes obedience. You know that song, Trust and Obey? There's no other way to be happy in Jesus than to trust and obey. And many times, in Deuteronomy 28, the blessings come when what? People love the Lord and obey His commandments. And many times in the Bible, it talks about obeying. In fact, in chapter in John, I believe it's chapter 15, it says, if you love me, Jesus spoke these words, you will obey me. You will obey me. Well, I want God to hear my prayers. I want Him to be moved by my prayers. How about you? I had received in the mail from Billy Graham Association, and he was writing about this. I just want to share a little bit of this. Pray. He's telling us to pray, I should say, just like my sign right here. See this? Pray. Because our nation's future depends on it. Our nation's future depends on it. America is in trouble. It's time for believers to stand up and take action to change the course of our nation. The place to begin is prayer. I want to encourage you to start praying for your spouse, your children, grandchildren, your great-grandchildren. Pray for the city, the government, for the state government, for our federal government, for Supreme Court judges, for your enemy. Pray for the peace of Israel. God commands that. Pray about everything. Every decision you have to make, pray and ask God for His guidance. Pray. And we also need to repent of a lot of things. Yes, we do. And we're going to read more about that here later. But we need to pray. We need to repent. We need to praise God. We need to go to Him for help, and then we need to what? Yield or be obedient to Him. Amen. 1 Kings 9:3 says, the Lord said to him, I have heard your prayer and your supplication, which you have made before me. Now, I want to go to 1 Kings, and I'm going to read from chapter 9, verses 1 through 8. Okay? And it came to pass, when Solomon had finished the building of the house of the Lord, and the king's house, and all Solomon's desires, which he was pleased to do, that the Lord appeared to Solomon the second time, as he had appeared to him at Gibeon. And the Lord said unto him, I have heard thy prayer and thy supplication, that thou hast made them before me. I have hallowed this house, which thou hast built, to put my name there forever, and my eyes and my heart shall be there perpetually. And if thou wilt walk before me, now hear this, if thou wilt walk before me as David thy father walked, in integrity of heart, and in uprightness, in holiness, to do according to all that I have commanded thee, and will keep my statutes and my judgments, then I will establish the throne of thy kingdom upon Israel forever, as I promised to David thy father, saying, there shall not fail thee a man upon the throne of Israel. But if ye shall at all turn from following me, ye or your children, and will not keep my commandments and my statutes which I have set before you, but go and serve other gods and worship them. Then will I cut off Israel out of the land which I have given them, and this house which I have hallowed for my name will I cast out of my sight, and Israel shall be a proverb and a byword among all people. And this house which is high, every one that passeth by it shall be astonished and shall hiss. And they shall say, why hath the Lord done thus unto this land and to this house? And they shall answer, now here's the answer, because they forsook the Lord their God, who brought their fathers out of the land of Egypt, and have taken hold upon other gods. They have worshipped them and served them. Therefore hath the Lord brought upon them all this evil, because they forsook the Lord our God. Does this sound like America today? I think it is. But I know God has a remnant. He has the church, those that are believers, born-again believers, that are standing on the Word. But we're going to have to really, like Franklin Graham says, we got to take action. We got to be spending more time in prayer. It amazes me that we took prayer out of schools, and look at the condition of our schools today. What goes on with our children's lives? And the church watched that and turned around, and what did they do? They removed prayer meetings. And many churches do not even have prayer at the altar. And that's something God's commanded us to do. If you don't believe me, you get in the Bible and read it. Right here, I'll tell you. He tells us to pray without ceasing. He does. He says to pray about everything. Pray about everything. Let's go to 2 Kings 25. Return and say to Hezekiah, the leader of my people, thus says the Lord, the God of your father David, I have heard your prayer. I have seen your tears. Behold, I will heal you. On the third day, you will go up to the house of the Lord. Now, I want to go to 2 Kings, and I want to read a little bit more of this. This is 2 Kings 20, verses 1 through 6. In those days was Hezekiah sick unto death, and the prophet Isaiah, the son of Amoz, came to him and said unto him, thus saith the Lord, set thy house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Then he turned his face to the wall, and he prayed unto the Lord, saying, I beseech thee, O Lord, remember now how I have walked before thee in truth, and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore, or wept very much. And it came to pass, afore, as Isaiah was going out into the middle court, what the word of the Lord came to him, saying, turn again and tell Hezekiah, the captain of my people, thus saith the Lord, the God of David thy father, I have heard thy prayer. I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will heal thee. On the third day thou shalt go up into the house of the Lord, and I will add unto thy days 15 years. I will deliver thee and the city out of the hand of the king of Assyria, and I will defend this city for my own sake and for my servant David's sake. He heard Hezekiah's prayers when he cried out to him. Well, we need to follow suit, I think. We need to cry out. I mean, he cried out. He really opened his heart up to the Lord, didn't he? And talked to him about his walk with him and how he trusted him. He trusted the Lord. He knew his strength was in the Lord. Amen. Let's go to Psalm 6:9. Of course, this is David wrote this psalm, and it says, the Lord has heard my supplication. The Lord receives my prayer. David knew that he could cry out to the Lord anytime and anywhere, from way back as a young man, shepherd boy on the hillside with the flocks. He knew he could talk to his father. I pray you know that you can talk to your father about anything, any need that you have. And I want to close with 2 Chronicles 7, 14 and 15. Very familiar. Some of us have it memorized. If my people, two letters, if. That's a pretty big word for just two letters, isn't it? If. My people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then. So first, we've got to humble ourselves. We got to know that we are nothing without God and we need Him for everything. We got to pray. We got to spend time with the Lord, talk to Him. We got to seek His face, not His blessings or what He'll hand out to us. We got to seek His face, His presence, and turn from their wicked ways. Is there something in your life today that you need to turn from? Well, we need to search our heart. Ask God to reveal it to us, and He will. He said, then will I hear from heaven, I will forgive their sin, and I will heal their land. Now my eyes shall be open and my ears attentive unto the prayer that is made in this place. We're going to have to be obedient. We're going to have to trust God. And we're going to have to spend time in prayer to see our nation, our schools, our homes, our families turn around. It's up to us. That two-letter word, if. Pretty big word, isn't it? You make the choice. Amen. Okay, we got some pictures from last week of studio taping. This is John Furness, and he is the host of The Simple Truth, a new program we have here at WTJR. And he was here to tape a couple of programs. And it's a Bible study program, and it airs on Monday evenings at 7:30 p.m. and on Sunday afternoon at 2:30 p.m. So you want to be sure and watch The Simple Truth. This is Jim Wilson, our engineer in Master Control Room. Nick took some vacation time, and so Jim is always so kind to go in there and work in Master Control. You see, there's a lot of screens, aren't there? That's behind the scenes for sure. This is a new set working on for Conquering Your Giants that's hosted by Duke Duvall. And he's been here, well, we're in our fourth year of taping, so we thought maybe it's time to change the set a little bit. And there we are, just getting set up. That's really behind the scenes pictures you see in there. I was on camera. We had to get the camera set. You got to set the lights got to be just right. And you see those blue X's on the carpet? Well, we marked it so the next time he comes, we'll have the furniture sitting in the right place according to the light setup. So this is really behind the scenes, and it's really interesting work. I'd love to see how God brings sets together and programs together. It's just amazing. Amen. Again, another shot. We're getting ready to tape. This is a picture of my newest grandson, Gabriel. And he and my daughter were here with me for a few days. And this is my daughter, Jody. And just what a joy to, I'll tell you, he's such a miracle. And babies, I'll tell you, I fell in love with him. He's got grandma's heart, that's for sure. And I know all you grandparents out there know exactly what I'm talking about, don't you? Amen. Okay, let's move on. I just want to talk a little bit more about the CTN Fall Telethon coming up here in a couple of weeks. It's planting the gospel seed for the sole purpose, and that's what you help us do when you support WTJR, is help us plant the gospel seed for the sole purpose. It affects people's lives for eternity. And that will be on September the 21st. That starts on a Monday evening at 5 p.m. It'll be live each evening. And then it will repeat after that. And it goes through the 26th of September. You can see some of these guest speakers there. But I really want to spend some time and invite you personally to come. We are going to have a pray-a-thon the same week as the telethon for 1 hour from 1 to 2 p.m. Monday through Friday right here in the WTJR studio. You can come and join us and we pray. You can pray individually. Sometimes we pray for each other. We do group prayer. But I would so be blessed if you would come and join us and stand with us in faith and pray, not only for the station here, but for our city, like I said, our home, our schools, our families, the nations, our government, business. There's so much to pray for, and we ask you to come and pray with us on September 21st through the Friday of that week from 1 to 2 right here at the studio. So Winning Training here at the WTJR studio on Fridays at 10 a.m. We go out on the streets, and if you've not been trained using the Soul Winning Script from the Great Awakening, we'll do that before we go out on the streets. Or if you'd like more information about the training, you can call the studio at 228-1616. Mexico 2015 Shoebox Ministry. That'll be here before we know it. And you will need to drop your shoeboxes off by Monday, November the 30th. And if you need a list of items you can put in the shoeboxes, again, you can stop by the studio, or if you give us a call, we'll send you one in the mail. But be getting your shoeboxes ready, and bless those children in Mexico. Amen. Aluminum pop tabs and the postage stamps we're still collecting. You can either mail them to us or drop them off by the studio, 222 North 6th Street. And if you need prayer, oh, I encourage you. We find it is an honor to pray with people. So Karen will answer the phone. She'll pray with you. And then call back your praise reports. And we get more and more of them all the time as we remind people to do that. Isn't that interesting how we so quickly sometimes forget to pray again and thank God? And so call in those praise reports. Or you can also send it to our email, tv16@wtgr.org. I'd encourage you to go on WTGR Facebook and friend us. A lot of information on our Facebook page each week. Community calendar tells about guests on different programs on WTGR. Just a lot of good information on WTGR Facebook. And if you have an event, please send your information 2 weeks ahead of time here to the studio. Be sure you include your name, address, city, and state. Again, there's our email address, or you can drop it in the mail, or just drop by the studio and visit us and give us your information. Several of you are blessed by the local programming we have here. Woman's Joy, Behind the Scenes, Pastor Speaks, Outreach Connection, Conquering Your Giants. If you'd like a copy of one of the programs, be sure you write down the date that it airs. And you can call us, and for a $10 donation, we will be glad to make a copy and send it to you. Next week on WTJR Classics is Golden Nuggets with Ron Wellman. This was recorded in February of 1997. It will air on Wednesday at 10 p.m., Thursday at 4:30 p.m., and Saturday at 12 noon. Coming up on the Billy Graham Association special, Heart of Compassion. That will air on Wednesday, September 16th at 1 p.m. and Friday, September 25th at 4 p.m. On Outreach Connection, hosted by Gary Schlockevier, we have Pat Beckman here from Quincy, Illinois, and he is with Adams County Right to Life. He's talking about some upcoming events in the month of October. Be sure and watch that on Monday the 14th at 9:30 a.m., Wednesday the 16th at 9 p.m., and Saturday the 19th at 7 p.m. And on Pastor Speaks, our guest pastor is Pastor Matt Dale. He is from House of Deliverance in Bowling Green, Missouri. He brought a message called From a Champion to a Clown. That it airs on Sunday the 13th at 2 p.m., Tuesday the 15th at 1:30 p.m., and Wednesday the 16th at 7:30 p.m. Family Movie Night coming up on Saturday, September 19th at 8 p.m., Sunday, September 20th at 11:30 p.m. will be A Letter to Dad. Very good movie, and I think you'll agree with me when you watch the promo that we have here to show you. Again, that's Saturday the 19th at 8 p.m. and Sunday the 20th
Remember
at
11:30 p.m. Remember that first day at the hot dog
stand? Yeah.
When I saw you, I got this wonderful feeling I haven't felt since I was a kid.
I bet you're this way with all the girls.
No.
A man searching for love will find a past he must fight to overcome.
All I ever wanted was to grow up to be just like my dad.
I'm not the cause for your messed up family life.
Dear Dad, I'm writing you this letter because I feel you should know me. And the only way you can fully understand who I am is you must know what I've gone through. I don't believe you know me. asked God why he was doing this to me. I had to make the best of it.
Sweetheart, let mommy in.
But inside I was dying. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I understood like a child. I thought like a child. But when I became a man, I put away my childish things.
I'm a man. I want to work. I want to do something with my life.
The Dove Foundation calls A Letter to Dad a powerful drama. Featuring songs by Jeremy Camp, Thousand Foot Crutch, Addie Camp, and Decipher Dow.
Dear Dad, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not turn from it. Your son, Dan.
A Letter to Dad, based on a true story. Now available at alettertodad.com.
And I think that'll be a good movie. How about you? And I believe I've seen that movie before and was blessed by it. But you know, there are a lot of movies I watch again because I get something the second time around. So I know we've had a lot of good movies, and I'm so thankful we've been able to bring them to you here at WTJR. I want to encourage you again about the CTN Fall Telethon. Please be in prayer about it. You know, when we stand together in prayer, things happen. And I've been emphasizing prayer for a year now because I felt like God wanted me to talk about prayer and encourage you to pray more, encourage myself. I need to pray more than I do. And again, we have the prayer-a-thon during the CTN Fall Telethon Week here at the WTJR studio from 1 to 2 p.m. Monday through Friday. If you can't come every day, that's fine. If you can come one day, oh, that would be great to have you join us with prayer. Because I truly believe that God hears and answers prayer. But as we read today, what? We got to trust Him. We got to believe. We've studied that for several weeks. And we got to what? Be obedient to what He asks us to do. So we can check our heart, search our heart, repent if we need to, humble ourselves, and turn from our wicked ways, and what? Then, he said, he would hear from heaven, he would forgive our sin first, and he would heal our land. We need healed. And we should love each other enough that we would give time to pray for one another, for our country, and for our nation. In Jesus' name, amen.
WTJR, licensed to Quincy, Illinois, maintains a public file for public inspection at our studio at 222 North 6th Street in Quincy, Illinois. Hours of our studio location.